I'm Dr. Ruchika Verma. I'm doing my postdoctoral fellowship from Department of Psychology, University of Allahabad. Before that, I was also working in Center for Women's Studies as a research associate. Today, I'm going to present the module on Veena Majumdar ji, which is one of the topics in paper 15, module 15, and under the topic Contemporary Pioneering Women. Veena Majumdar ji doesn't need any grand introduction, but I am fortunate enough to present about Veena ji, and this module is going to present the detailed account of Veena ji, and this module is an attempt to understand an extraordinary woman, Veena Majumdar, who was popularly known as a women activist, a feminist, a troublemaker, a gender specialist, a recorder and chronicle of Indian women's movement, and obviously the grandmother of women's studies in South Asia. My presentation is going to be divided into mainly five main broad topics. First, I'm going to start with a brief biographical sketch about Veena Majumdar ji, then a post-independence account of women's status in India, and then about the most significant event in the most significant contribution of Veena Majumdar, that is the writing of Towards Equality report in the year 1974. Moreover, the fourth topic will introduce you about the institutional contribution of Veena Majumdar in the form of Indian Association of Women's Studies and Center for Women and Development Studies in Delhi. Besides that, I will also talk about major contribution of Veena Majumdar ji in the area of academics, broadly in women's studies. To begin with the biographical sketch, Veena Majumdar ji, born in the year 1927 in a middle class family of Bengal. She was the youngest of five children in her family. She had three elder brothers and one elder sister. Her mother was a strong motivational force for Veena ji to pursue her studies, because at that time women going for studies was a very, very rare phenomena, and Veena ji got this motivation strongly from her mother. She entered school at the age of 8 years, and the major role for her education was played by Veena ji's driver, who used to teach him alphabets and numbers. She did her schooling from St. John's Diocesan Girls' School in Kolkata. Then after that, the journey didn't stop anywhere. From the strong motivation from the mother and other family members also, gradually Veena ji started her graduation studies at Women's College, Banaras Hindu University, and subsequently at Ashutosh College, the University of Calcutta. Then she became the secretary of the Ashutosh College Girls Students Union, which shows that she was really very active right from her childhood as well as during her college days showed her inclination towards fighting for the rights of girls. While at the college, she organized a meeting in the support of Rama Rao Committee, which recommended expansion of inheritance rights for daughters through crucial Hindu law reform. Because at that time, Hindu law reform was established, and that was the time when Veena ji challenged the first person to emphasize on the daughter's right in the family. Then in 1947, just after independence, she went to St. Hugh's College, where she completed her graduation in 1951, and then returned to Oxford University in 1960, and she completed her DPhil in 1962. A major contribution of Veena Majumdar ji was through her writings before any other. She brought to the forefront the analysis and evaluation of women's participation in nationalist movement, because Veena Majumdar witnessed the struggle for freedom, and she, as an adolescent, as a young girl, she was witnessing the contribution of women in the nationalist movement. And in front of her eyes, when the country got independence, she was compelled to analyze the situation and see how the women's position in the society was changing. One such excellent work was which also put forth the women's question done by her along with Leela Kasturi was her paper Women and Indian Nationalism. That paper was a landmark in the Veena ji's career, and that was the most significant writing by Veena ji and Leela ji, because that was the time when there was a need to strike the importance of women in the nationalist movement, because nobody was realizing at that time, and the India's economic and social development was in the forefront. Some important issues were raised by Veena ji. First, whether women's participation was really acknowledged in the historical artifacts, whether the women's this issue was significantly important, because Veena ji questioned first important issue, that whether the women's contribution in the nationalist movement or freedom for struggle for freedom, whether that particular contribution has been acknowledged in the history or not. Second, whether women's movement from the domestic to public sphere was noticed by their male counterparts, and was there any relief given in them in their traditional household roles. That was a very, very significant aspect which was emphasized by Veena ji, that when for the first time women were asked to move out from their domestic sphere, from the four boundaries of their houses whether their movement from domestic to public sphere was acknowledged by the male counterparts or not, because that was the most important aspect, whether male were acknowledging the contribution of women folk or not. Then third issue which was addressed was, why were the contribution of males were overemphasized, and there was not much attention given to the contribution of women and children during the struggle for freedom. And the last issue which was addressed was, did women's participation also facilitate women's movement? This was the breakthrough, and that was the opening of the thought for many thinkers, that when the women was asked to move out of their houses, to leave their domestic spheres, to leave their lines of securities, and then they were asked to move out, and that whether it was the beginning of the women's movement, because that was the time when women first of all was made aware of their worth. Then the second important issue which we are going to address in the Veena ji's an important and significant contribution is towards equality report, that is the status of women report. Contributing in different ways through academics and through activism, Veena ji was member secretary for the Committee on Status of Women in India, and there were other some renowned people who were working with her were Dr. Full Renu Guha, Maniben Kara, Savitri Shyam, Neera Dogra ji, Vikram Mahajan, Leela Dubey, Sakina A. Hasa, Urmila Haksar and Lotika Sarkar. This was the team which was made to develop the Status of Women report in the year 1974. Now, the research for the Committee of Status of Women report for India, there was the whole research was required, and that report was a big challenge for people who were at that time working. Veena ji was very, very much worried about the fact that how the research will be conducted on the issues of women, the status of women in India. And then he took help from some of the prominent people in different fields. Some among them were Shiv Kumar Mitra, then Professor Durganand Sinha from psychology, Professor Siris Kar, Professor Iqbal Narayan. These people helped Veena ji a lot in conducting research surveys and compiling the facts about the women's status in India. Then another important institutional contribution by Veena ji is the Center for Women's Development Studies. The Center for Women Development Studies was established on 19th April 1980. in the middle of the International Women's Decade, because that was the time, 1975 to 1985 was declared as the Women Decade, and that was the time when Southeast Asian countries were asked to give their status of women report so that they can get maximum funding from the various developed countries. So that was a very important issue for the social, political and economical development of any developing country. So that is why the decade 74 to 75 to 85 has been declared as the International Women's Decade. Then during that decade, by a group of men and women who were involved in the preparation of first ever comprehensive government report on the status of women in India, entitled Towards Equality, Report of the Committee on the Status of Women in India. This was the name of the report, and who were later associated with the Women's Studies program were Indian Council of Social Science Research, that which is popularly known as ICSSR. So ICSSR also contributed later on along with UGC to develop this Status of Women report, because that was a landmark in the development of women's movement in India. A few months later, under the leadership of late Professor J.P. Nayak, the CWDS was registered under the Society's Registration Act, because that was the time when Veenaji established Center for Women and Development Studies, and in a way the center also contributed a lot in conducting research for the Status of Women report. And it was registered in New Delhi and started functioning since May 1980 with a small financial grant from the Vikram Sarabhai Foundation under the chairpersonship of Dr. Fulrenu Guha and Dr. Veena Majumdar as the director. So Veena ji became the director of the CWDS, and she established CWDS as an active organization which was determined to work in the area of research, to work in the research area of women studies. In 1984-85, on the recommendation of a visiting committee appointment by the Indian Council of Social Science Research, CWDS began to receive an annual maintenance fund from the ICSSR and became recognized as one of the research institutes supported by ICSSR. So with the supporting hand from ICSSR, CWDS started flourishing and started making its pillars more and more strong, and the research in the area of women's studies started establishing in India. Following the mandate of the 1981 National Conference on Women's Studies, those who were in the forefront of that conference met in 1982 and established the Indian Association of Women's Studies. Indian Association of Women's Studies was another major organizational contribution by Veena Majumdar ji, because Veena ji was very much interested into including women's studies as in the main academics, in the main discipline, and as a part of curriculum in colleges and university level. And some of the people who prominently helped Veena ji in the establishment of Indian Association of Women's Studies were Neera Desai ji, Maitri Krishnaraj ji, Madhuri Shah, Kumud Sharma, Hemlata Swaroop, and not to forget Professor J.P. Nayak ji. Because Indian Association of Women's Studies is at present the strongest organization which propagate and which help in establishing women's studies department in various universities and colleges in India. The parliamentary mandate to use women's studies as an instrument for social engineering. Women's studies as a subject was explained as the instrument for social engineering. It was considered as the only instrument which can bring about equality in the society, reduce the discrimination between males and females, and through the National Policy on Education in 1986 marked a culmination of the efforts initiated a decade back. So along with National Policy of Education and the parliamentary mandate, women's studies was introduced as a strong subject at the various college and university levels. But during that workshop, Veena ji's ideas on national policy for education were very important. This workshop was conducted by National Policy of Education, and she warned the people that women's studies jointly that the implementation of the mandate will not depend on government but on the wider active and effective participation by persons and institutions. So it is not going to be an agenda of the government, but social engineering itself involves involvement of all social organizations at different levels, be it individual, social, family, educational, political, legal. All social organizations need to participate and then bring about change in the society. Now now we will talk about the main academic endeavors, because Veena ji's contribution in the area of women's studies is incomplete without giving due importance to her academic endeavors. First important academic contribution was done by Veena ji in the year 1972, which was Education and Social Change, Three Studies on 19th Century India, and this was published by Indian Institute of Advanced Studies in the year 1972. This contribution was done by Veena ji when she was working there as a research fellow for a very brief period, but she contributed a major research contribution and saw the effect of education on social change. Then the second important academic contribution is Role of Rural Women in Development, University of Sussex, Institute of Development Studies, Allied Publisher. Another remarkable contribution by her was Symbols of Power, Studies on the Political Status of Women in India. Gradually, Veena ji's academic contribution were focused on more and more women related topics, and they were more and more focused towards bringing about the change in the social world, because that was the time when society was demanding a change, a major change in the country, and that was the awareness of women for education and employment, because that was the time, the decade, International Women's Decade 75 to 85, that was the time when a major change took place in the educational and occupational status of women. Then another important contribution was Emergence of Women's Transition in India and the Role of Women in the Center for Women's Development Studies. So gradually we can see from the contributions that Veena ji was interested in understanding the women issues. Khadi and Village Industries Commission, which was again a contribution which was done by CWDS in the year 1988. Then Face to Face with Rural Women, CWDS, Search for New Knowledge, and an interventionist role. So not only doing research on the fact finding, Veena ji also emphasized on an interventionist approach, because she was not only interested in finding the facts, but also finding the problems, but also on how to solve it. That was the trend which was started by Veena ji in the year 2002, and many disciplines, even in India, they are looking at the women's issues from a fact finding perspective. They just want to find out what is the problem. But now is the time that when women issues should be seen from a perspective of interventionist approach. Unless and until we see the problem from an interventionist approach, we cannot bring about a concrete change in the situation. And a very popular contribution by Veena ji in the year 2010 was Memories of a Rolling Stone, which was published by Zuban Books, because this was an autobiographical explanation of Veena ji. And not to miss that Veena ji was addressed by her elder brother as the Rolling Stone, because she used to switch on her jobs very frequently. Her professional career reflects that she switches, keeps on changing her jobs after 6 months, 1 year, and as a result, he used to say her that you are a rolling stone, moving from one place to another. And finally, Veena ji died with an important academic and a leading figure of India's women's movement. Veena ji died on 30th May 2013 after a brief illness. There were some tumors in her lungs, and she was survived by 3 daughters and a son. So we can conclude by saying that it is very difficult that a person like Veena Majumdar ji cannot be, when we will get a person like Veena Majumdar in India who will contribute in the manner she did, and she changed the whole scene of India regarding women's situation. Thank you.